stayed patient, and I never took the, you know, they dangle the carrot in front of your face, you know what I mean, or mm-hmm. whatever thing is. Like mm-hmm. I never took the close.
Never went after the shiny object.
Exactly.
Yeah. And these kids come up to me and they tell me the same thing now. And it's like, and sometimes, and there's nothing wrong with that, you inspire me. But it's when it's at an unhealthy level that I fear. And I feel like for the majority of us, our fascination and our interest in celebrities and what they do for us,
it's an unhealthy level.
Is unhealthy.
Persistence is important, because let's say you want something really bad and you keep trying and you keep trying and you keep trying, and on the 10th try you don't get it still, and then you say, okay, it must be a sign that I need to stop doing what I need to do. But what if you didn't know that on your 11th try you would have made it? You would have made it happen and got what you wanted to get. So I feel like persistence is important, because if you really truly love something and you truly believe, you should just do it for the love, and you don't get to where you're going, you still were doing something you love. So persistence is very important, for sure.
I thought about basketball, why I ain't making it basketball. Nigga, I love to play. And at this point, I'm 21 years old, you know what I mean, 22. And I'm like, nigga, why you didn't make it in basketball? Because you wasn't fucking working. You thought you'd be outside dribbling the fucking ball, doing something, when really niggas was in the gym with trainers, like putting in work, shooting 1,000 shots a day. And your dumb ass over there thinking you doing something, mimicking Iverson. So it was like, yo, do you really want to look back 10, 20 years from now with this music shit and be like, the reason you didn't make it in music because you ain't put in the work? So I was like, fuck it. That was where the warm-up came from. Every day, nigga, I woke up, wrote verses, made beats.
I was always hesitant to do what was being offered.
Getting out of your comfort zones is the fastest way for growth. It's hard to grow when you're comfortable. You're not stretching yourself, you're not stretching your limits, you know, you're just in your comfort zone. So when I left a small city in North Carolina, 200,000 people, 150,000 people, and came to New York with 8 million, 10 million people, I was for sure uncomfortable. But just like you interviewing Jay-Z, I felt some nerves, but more importantly, I felt focused and I felt ready for the task. So I had to get out of my comfort zone to make it happen.
This past 5 years has been a fight against comfort. I was chilling. What I noticed was, with that feeling of comfort, I'm like, damn, this is the moment that a lot of your favorite rappers hit a crossroad where they did what the fuck they set out to do, and then the fruits of their labor started working against them. That same energy and that same, like, passion they put into the craft was gone, and it was replaced by, like, comfort and luxury.
While I set these ground rules for myself, she mentioned the meditation, and she had explained to me, like, how her experience with it and like how life-changing it was and how clear she felt, boom, boom. So I was like, you know what? I was out in LA, like I had came out here to work on the album. I had the album titles, 2014 Forest Hills Drive. I had it all mapped out. I knew what the album was gonna be called. I knew I was gonna buy the house back. It all felt like it was like supposed to happen. And I started adding that. By the time 5 months hit, I would have these revelations and clarity about my life. And I would see what was actually happening in my life and where I was headed.
Are you okay? We're getting comfortable, chilling, mailing it in, waiting around on inspiration. If this is as high as you ever got, not career success-wise, but from a skill level, like have you wrote your best song? Did you leave no stone unturned creatively? And when I thought about that feeling, I was like, nah, I'm not cool with that.
I had set rules for myself. One was like, bro, you can't go on social media no more. Like, okay. We're from the first generation of like entertainers, celebrities, whatever, where it's like, bro, you could literally at any minute see what somebody's saying about you, you know what I mean? And it's like, there was nobody to tell you, like cigarettes. When the whole world for decades was smoking cigarettes, there wasn't anybody loudly saying like, that's gonna kill you. And about, you probably shouldn't do that. It took a long time for somebody to realize how harmful this was.
Yeah. About 2 years into being a father, I remember like, oh, you need a schedule where your family knows that this is your time in the studio, and this is the time when I'm at home on family mode. It's something that I needed to do because I'm not gonna shortcut on the family side. So I put the studio in the house for that reason. It's like, I love being able to work knowing my family is right upstairs.
Like, you have a successful album, they wanna renegotiate right away. Mm-hmm. And the artist is like, yeah, I do that because you're going to get another million, boom, boom. Yeah, they want to renegotiate, but it's like they're going to tack on how many albums for that. So it's like, I was like, oh, I got these successful albums. I'm going to chill I'm not gonna just renegotiate, I'm good on that, boom, boom. And the longer I waited, the better my leverage played out for me when it came time. You know, it's like, and I still apply that to this day. I'm like, I'm very slow to do those types of deals because I'm like, yo, I don't know yet. Let me feel this out. Why? You know what I mean? Let me take a little more time. And the more time you take, the more the truth starts to show itself. You know what I mean? It's like, so.
You know what I mean? I know what it's like to be that kid. Like, well, I'm going to read. You know, when I was in high school and middle school, like, well, I'm going to read outside of what I already got to do for class. It's something that you think you wouldn't do, but now as a grown man, I feel like I missed out. I feel like I wish I would have read way more when I was younger. And now I'm trying to catch up. You know what I mean? I'm trying to, like, play catch up.
I put too much of my purpose in music to where when I'm home and I come home, outside of like playing with my son, if I go 3 days without doing music, making a beat, writing a song, I start to feel like miserable. And I feel like it's cause I haven't found purpose or placed purpose in other things. I don't care if it's taking out the garbage. There's certain things that—
Maintaining a household.
Yes. Mm-hmm. There's certain things that people excuse you from doing when you like, when you're chasing something or like you have a career like this where it's like, you know, I got people that handle my business, my affairs.
Every time you say no, and like while battling like an addiction, it's like you get stronger. You add a pebble to your strength, you know what I mean?